Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about API gateway pattern, which can also have a service registry or service discovery kind of a logic. Okay, so what we have is we have our couple of different microservices. Okay, those microservices will be exposed and there will be an API gateway to which user will be connecting with. So let's say we are including the API gateway which is provided by AWS. It's nothing but you can put any gateway here. Okay, so user is connecting directly to the API gateway and then API gateway is deciding how to route the request to a different microservices which we have. Okay, so consider that this API gateway is nothing but a Node.js microservice. We are not talking about AWS API gateway or Azure API gateway. Okay, so let's consider that this is a Node.js microservice which will just take the request and will try to route this request to a particular microservice. And here we are going to have a service discovery, service registry. The objective of service registry is to manage the registry of all up and running services. Okay, service registry we have here. Service registry can have its a small database where it will just contain the mapping of all different services which we have. Okay, it can be a small database. Okay, this is our service registry. So API gateway will be in sync with service registry. It will be a two-way arrow. We can get it. Okay, now what do we have is we have service registry which has its database, means it will have the record of all the up and running microservices and their meta information. Now whenever the request is coming for a different set of microservices, what will happen is we will actually redirect it to a different services. Now service registry will hold the information about what all microservices are currently up and running. So from service registry, you will be able to add new service, remove new service. So whenever a new request is coming, then service registry will always be able to help us to identify which service is up and running. Okay, so we can just tag each and every service here. Okay, this consider that this is a login service, or you can say auth service. This is your order service. And this is your log service where you might be using ELK or something else. Okay, and these services will also have a sync up or communication with service registry. So whenever they are coming up, then they are registering themselves to the service registry. Let's make this little small. Now we can just pair it like this. Okay, so order service will also have a communication with service registry to notify that this is up and running and healthy. Okay, so all these services are actually directly communicating and they have their own database because these all are microservices. Okay, so to orchestrate this kind of a structure on your local system, you can create a Node.js service which will serve as an API gateway. Okay, you will just create the instance of API gateway and you will just pass what service you want to talk to, like login service, order service, log service. So your API gateway will give us the redirection to a particular service. It's not only a routing or redirection, but in service registry this API gateway will hold the information what all services are up and running, and this API gateway will create an object of that particular service and hand it over to the request. Now either you are just making an HTTP request, you will say okay, login request, service registry holds the information, okay, login service is available, up and running. Let's make a call, redirect a call to the service login, service sign up, all these services can be up and running. And we can actually orchestrate this simple service example using Docker Compose or simple Node.js services. Okay, what we will have a simple service registry. Okay, this can be a simple Node.js service talking to a database, and it will hold the information of all the services which are running. So we can have all the HTTP services running on different port. Okay, and we will define all the routes which are configured on each and every services, like log service, log authentication service, order service. What are their endpoints, so that whenever the request is coming, this API gateway should have the information where to redirect the request, where to redirect the user. Okay, so let's talk about that in the terms of code, and we'll see that in the next video with the proper hands-on.